Good recipes don't have to be difficult or either too expensive. Today I'm going to show you that with two ingredients that I had in the fridge, I can make a nice and cheap recipe. It's a dinner saver, quick and too easy to make. For two people. It's good a 10-inch diameter pan, even a pot or a casserole dish. Whatever it is, just not so big. And two fennels to start. Then, we'll see if that's the case, we'll add some other vegetables as well. Remove the root end, which is always slightly oxidized and tough. The outer leaves, we pull them off by hand, the larger ones like this. This one is pretty nice. So we use it as is, or at least if you see it's a little ugly, you can clean it up. Or pull the filaments off. You see that? These are like threads. These are a little tough. The heart of the fennel, cut off just the last inch of stem. And then cut it in half. The inner stalks are very tender, but don't cut them too small because if you do, they'll mash up later. On the other hand, the outer peels have more soil that are a bit bigger and harder too. From the stem, you have to take off the first centimeter on top. And then you have to peel it slightly because the outer part is a little bit hard. So we also use the stems and we cut it. This operation should be done after washing them. But today, it goes like this. We cut the hearts bigger because they are tender. The outer parts, we cut them finer because they're harder. So we even out the cooking time. Wash it very well. A knob of butter without overdoing it. But you can also use virgin olive oil as you wish, but with butter it's better. And now I'll add fennel. By the way, I will then add a magic touch to this recipe, which is a trivial thing that makes the difference. Since the fennel is not enough, and I also want a splash of color, I add a thinly sliced carrot to it. If you want, you can also add other seasonal vegetables to this recipe. For example, when it's fennel season, there is also cauliflower, broccoli, cabbage, or just potatoes. I also want to put two cauliflowers in it after cleaning, cutting, and washing them. Cauliflower. A little bit of salt, we put it in now, so veggies will release water immediately. A bay leaf to taste if you like, if not, no problem. Half a cup of water. Now for the magic touch. We take Ugo, who has lost another tooth like me, and an orange. An orange with an edible peel. We cut away a tiny, thin little strip that we'll need later. One, no more. And then we cut the rest in half. And we squeeze our nicely juicy orange. How beautiful it is, a little at a time. I add all the juice from the orange to my vegetables. I have to do it twice because tools are what they are. Just a little peel, huh? Pull the whites off well because they can also be quite bitter. In any order. Give it a good stir. A mixture and lid. Reduce the heat and cook for 15 minutes. So after these 10 or 15 minutes of cooking, you will see that our vegetables are ready. Let's make sure we don't overcook them. Cooking with the lid on and adding a little bit of water. You know, cooking with a little bit of water and the lid on, it's like steaming, which keeps our vegetables nicely cooked. Moist and perfect. We said we were going to make a quick and cheap dinner saver, so now we need to make this a one-pot meal. So I make room for two eggs inside the vegetables, and I put one egg in each hole. Cover 2 or 3 minutes, just the time for the eggs to cook a little. And after 2 minutes, I like them a little soft, see? So I leave them that way, but if you want them more cooked, add another minute. Sprinkle with Parmesan or other cheese, but if you like, you can also add melted mozzarella to the eggs. And the great thing about this recipe, besides it's cheap, you make it fast. With one pan, you make food for everybody. Another thing about this recipe is that you take a piece of bread, this here. It's the bread I made at Christmas. The one left over and I froze and I took it out today and dip. Dip into the egg or dip into the vegetables, eat the vegetables, and then eat vegetables, pick some bread and soak into. It's a simple, good, easy thing. Or you take your little fennel or cauliflower or carrot, you soak it in the little egg. Cooked? Cauliflower, do you not soak it? We are not here for discrimination. Cauliflower is softer. It is perfectly cooked those 10-15 minutes. Don't overcook because you ruin its flavor and the vitamins. Delicious. There's the orange that gives it that orangey tone, which is spectacular. The carrot, do you not taste it? There is no discrimination on my channel. Crunchy, it's so good. The orange just gives it that extra touch. Guys, do it. What should I tell you? Do it, do it, do it. Cheap and fast with one pan. Guys, I was told by the director that I never say subscribe it and all that stuff. So subscribe. There are thousands, thousands, thousands of you out there who follow my channel without being subscribed, and I'm happy. But subscribing it, which is free for you, it doesn't cost you anything, you give us a big hand. Also because then we can maybe buy a new camera that this one is going to leave us. So we will make better videos. Bye.